Welcome back to the Art Room, Mrs. Larrabee here. This week we're going to be making a collage together. A collage is when we take different materials and we glue them onto one canvas together. So this week we're going to be taking different materials of paper. We're going to be gluing them together to make a piece of artwork. So this week you're going to need paper. You don't need a lot of paper, but you do need different kinds of paper. So definitely grab a white sheet of paper. You need a full sheet as our background. But then any kind of little scrap paper that you might have, construction paper, paper bag, that would work for today. We want several different colors, maybe four or five different colors if you can find it. Things that would also work would be tissue paper, or this is like crepe paper, like the streamers that you would have up for a birthday party. Wrapping paper would work as well. And raid your recycle bin, the paper from the newspaper or the ads from the grocery store would work because those all have color on them too. So you'll need a small little bit of different colored paper. You need your scissors, your glue, and a black coloring supply. If you don't have any other kind of paper, you're somewhere, I know sometimes we're doing art lessons and we're not at home where we can get supplies, then grab a sheet of paper and your coloring supply. You can draw along with us as we're making our collage. All right, grab those supplies. We'll get started. We're going to be looking at the Japanese culture this week. The reason is that there's a holiday this week called Children's Day. It's celebrated on May 5th, which falls on Wednesday this week. Children's Day is a day where families and the community looked at the happiness, the health, and growth of the children around them. It's a day for families to spend time together. They celebrate. If you're curious about finding more, our K through second grade lesson tells a little bit more about how they celebrate. We're going to be looking just a little bit more at the Japanese culture as a whole, specifically culinary arts. Culinary arts is the art of food. It's how the food is prepared and presented. And Japan does such a beautiful job in their tradition of the food sushi. Sushi is a rice-based food that is made using different types of fish and things that you might find in the ocean, such as seaweed, together to make these really unique and delicious rolls. They're even displayed in unique ways. Sometimes the fish is left on top. That looks kind of cool. Sometimes they're displayed in the shape of a dragon, as in the dragon roll. There's several different ways that can be done as well. Sushi generally has the rice and this wrap of seaweed in common, though. It's traditionally eaten either with the hands or with chopsticks. And on the side, you might find things like wasabi, which is that really green, very spicy sauce, as well as candied ginger, which usually has this pink. You might see it on the side, and it could be served with soy sauce. The first thing you need to do is grab your paper. All right, we're going to start with a background for our plate. So let's start by thinking about what kind of plate we're going to have our sushi on. I used a white background with a little piece of brown paper on top. It's actually a brown paper bag. I chose to make mine into the size of a square. You could make it into a rectangle as well, but I've cut a square out and I'm going to glue this square on top. And this is just going to make like the outside edge and then the bottom of my plate. Remember, as you're gluing, you want to make sure that you get your glue around the edges because that's the part that we really need to stick. And then you can flip your paper over and give it a little rub to make sure that it all lays down nice and neat. All right, so we have our plate made. Now we're going to add a little pattern to it. Like I said, in culinary arts, it's all about how the food is displayed. In this case, how our sushi is displayed. And sometimes they add these really beautiful and intricate plates to the side. So here's a couple of examples. I have this one with some wavy lines in the side that's made the pattern. This one's just with a straight line across the edge, which actually I got this idea from our Keith Haring art lesson that we did before winter break, where we used these lines on the flooring in that lesson. Think about, you could even use just shapes, circles, squares, triangles in the background, something to decorate the outside edge. Do that and then come back and I'll show you how we're gonna start our collage. We have our design on the outside of our plate and now we're ready to begin creating our sushi. All right, so sushi is generally made into a roll and it's cut into pieces, and what you see when it sits up is more of a circle. So we're gonna start with that. Let's make one together. We'll talk about a few ideas that we might have. Generally, it has seaweed around the edges. So we're gonna put our scissors down for a while. We're gonna rip our paper to form the outside edge of our seaweed. There's different kinds of sushi from what can be in there. There's one that's called the California roll. You might be familiar with that. It has avocado in it, which a lot of things Californian named have avocado in it, since we grow a lot of them here. So be thinking about what you're going to put inside your sushi. So we have our green around the edge. This is yours. You are the culinary artist right now, so you could decide to have purple seaweed on the outside or orange seaweed on the outside. I'm going to let you guys have your creative freedom there as the culinary artist. The inside is rice. So generally rice is going to be white or brown rice. I guess you could get creative there too. We're just going to tear little pieces until we have it all filled up. All right, so we have the seaweed outside. We have the rice on the inside. Now you get to start making it. So we mentioned that California roll. You might want to add a little green for avocado. And then some type of fish or crab meat, which might be a little more of the red or pink color. And maybe even a little yellow. I'm not exactly sure what the yellow would be in the middle, but you know, so you'd glue those down too. We want to have at least three pieces of sushi on our plate. You can have more than that if you would like. You could even do them in that dragon pattern, like we saw in some of the examples. That'd be kind of cool. It doesn't have to be realistic. Like I said, if you want to make the outside a different color, that's fine. Even the inside a different color. I would ask that they stay in the circle, so at least they're in the same shape. But, you know, you could make mac and cheese sushi. You could make pizza sushi. I don't know. There's all sorts of ideas that you could come up with. Go ahead and add at least two more, so you have a total of three. You could add more sushis to your plate. And then meet me back here one more time, and we'll talk about how to wrap this up. Okay, so we have at least three sushi on our plate. I did try the mac and cheese one. I thought about making this one into a pizza sushi, but I just couldn't. I just needed a real piece of sushi there. So I can't wait to see what you guys come up with. I know you've been creative. So the next thing we need to do is add our chopsticks. Now this could be eaten with your hands too, but chopsticks are kind of fun to make. I just cut them out of black paper, so I went back to my scissors. That was a little easier than trying to rip them. And I added just a little bit of detail to the top. It's up to you how you want to decorate them. And it would be kind of cool to add a little bit of wasabi. Wasabi is that green spicy paste that you might get on the side with your sushi. And if you had some pink paper, you could add a little ginger to the side too. That's one of my favorite toppings on there. When you get everything glued on, you might want to flip it over, give it one last press on the back so that all those little pieces of paper of collage that we put on there will stick nicely. And looking at mine, I feel like there's just a little something missing. The plate feels just a little plain. So I'm going to go back and just kind of add the outline edge of my plate. Just a little extra design added to it. You may have added more sushi to your plate. You may feel like you're good and you don't need it, but I think that just kind of helps finalize it. So here we are. We've given a nod to culinary arts with our sushi collage patterns. I can't wait to see what you guys have come up with. I bet you guys have been creative in how you've done yours. I'll see you back here next week in the art room.